wrestling fans, and welcome to USWA Championship Wrestling. My name is Michael St. John, and you're set for an action-packed hour of great wrestling excitement. You'll see on the program the USWA World Tag Team Champions, the Dirty White Boys in action, with their manager, Ronnie P. Gossett, also the sensational star, Jeff Jarrett, and the Southern Heavyweight Champion, Superstar Bill Dundee, accompanied by the lovely Tessa. And the big news of the week, around the world, we have a brand new, unified World Heavyweight Champion. That's right, you heard me right. A brand new unified World Heavyweight Champion. We're going to tell you all about it and how it came about. But first, let's take this break. We'll be set for action right after these messages. Wrestling fans, as I told you in the opening, a brand new unified World Heavyweight Champion, and somewhat of a surprise, yes, the Snowman has won the belt from Jerry the King Lawler in a recent match at the arena, and boy, it sort of shocked the world of wrestling. I can assure you it was a big, big shock. Let's go back now in time and see how this all developed. It started off in the studio in Memphis, Tennessee, Jerry the King Lawler making an interview when suddenly he's interrupted. Take a look.
I'm going to wrestle Jerry Lawler, and that's who I want. I come out here to give him an open challenge.
You're not challenging him. You're challenging my company, and I'm not going to put up with it. Now, I'll put you on the card Monday night, Snowman, but won't be in against him. You'll be against somebody else. Wait till I get through, and then you can talk. You can work your way up just like all the rest of them.
I'm not working my way up anywhere.
Well, then you're not getting a title shot.
Look, man, y'all been doing me wrong around here for years. Let me tell you something. That's all right. I got some people here from Scores Production.
I don't care who
they know exactly what I'm talking about and everything I've been trying to do in this town.
I don't care who you got with you.
Look, I've been to you. I called Lala.
Yes.
I called him up and told him what I want.
You don't
I told
ask him. You ask me. You call
I ain't
me
working. I ask you, and he hides behind you.
You can have a match Monday night. You can pick your opponent, but not Lala. You work your way up, and then you'll get a title match.
I hear what you're saying. Lawler is not these people's champion. That's what I'm saying.
Well, what it is about he's got the belt, and you can just get right out of here, or you can sit down.
Hold it. Let me tell you something, Lawler. It's one more thing.
Hold up for a minute. Let me hear you. Hold it.
Let me tell you something, Dave Brown. Lawler, you are not a champion, and I'm sick and tired of you putting out on my people. I'm sick and tired of you putting all on the black people. You understand me? All this stuff about welfare checks, food stamps. I'm sick and tired of you, boy. You know what it is, Lord? It's because I'm black, that's all.
You're trying to make it racial where you can get all the blacks on your side. But all the blacks are not on your side, Snowman, because we've got black wrestlers.
You don't have one black wrestler to take this man out.
J.Y.D. came in. He's a top.
J.Y.D. ain't nothing.
Rick House Brown is black. And
nothing. It's nothing.
To your benefit, so you're thinking it's nothing.
Let me tell you something.
Hey, you can either step down and shut up.
I'm not saying nothing. I'm not going to do nothing, sir. You hear from my people over here.
Let me tell you something. No, hey, come here. Come over here. I thought you came out here to do some talking. Move all the way. Let him talk. Hey, listen. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you what your problem is.
What is my problem?
I'm going to tell you what it is. You want to come out here and, yeah, go ahead. Take your shirt off. Show your big muscle up body. You want to come out here and try to get something. Let me talk to him. Stand over here.
All you do is ask this man hiding behind you every Saturday.
Hey, I ain't hiding behind nobody. I'm standing right here, and I'm telling you right to your face. If you think I'm scared of you, you got another thing coming, brother. We don't have to.
You are scared of me.
No, I ain't scared of you. I ain't scared of nobody. But let me tell you what your problem is, Snowman.
Yeah, what's my
you
want
to try to make an excuse. You want to try to say that the reason you don't get title shots is because you're black. That's got absolutely nothing to do with
it.
You're
black,
using
brother.
That as an excuse.
It's because I'm black.
No, it's because you won't take the time and trouble to work your way up to a title shot.
I'm not working my way
okay,
up to a title shot. I want you.
Yeah. Well,
he's going to get one.
Who have you wrestled?
I'm going to get one else. He's going to see me everywhere he goes.
Well, he might see you everywhere he goes, but he ain't going to see you no more today. So
yes, he is. He damn sure going to see me some more today.
Sit down, or I'll personally escort you out of this place. Get out of here.
Snowman ejected from the television studio that day. He said he would show up at the Mid-South Coliseum and buy a ticket to the match. Indeed, that's what happened. Take a look.
Jerry the King Lawler. As security escorting him out.
The USWA, under pressure from its board of directors, had to allow Snowman time on television to state his side of the story and challenge Jerry the King Lawler. Here's what happened.
King Cobra's been with this company ever since he started in the wrestling business.
That's the problem.
He's made a name for himself. He's helped the world heavyweight belt. He's helped the southern heavyweight belt. And not only do I consider him a top wrestler, a top athlete, a top contender, I also consider him a personal friend. That's and you're okay. Not going to mistreat him because he is my personal guest today.
He should be your personal guest, and he also got a lot of fans, doesn't he, down in my hometown around Greenwood, Greenville. They know that he ain't going to keep no bill.
Well, King Cobra is not the issue today, Snowman. King Cobra is not. You're the issue. So get what you got in your crawl out so we can get on with our wrestling program.
All right, go ahead and let him talk.
Right. Well, like I said, I really don't have anything to say. It just,
why you don't have anything to say?
I've wrestled in this organization. I wrestled in other organizations, and belts and matches are won in the ring.
Let me ask you this. In the length of time you've been with the CWA, the USWA, anytime, anywhere, any place, and be honest with me, because there's millions of people watching, has anything ever come up that would be, in your mind, racially motivated? Just answer truthfully.
Don't lie.
With the organization, no. Every individual have problems with another wrestler, but with the organization, no. These people over here, they're not with the organization, so they wouldn't know.
Can I call one of my men over here?
I don't care, Snowman, but we need to hurry up and get this on.
Yeah, we do.
This is a wrestling program,
not a talk show.
It's a wrestling program. Come on over. Who is this, Snowman? These are the black businessmen in the Memphis area that represent all people that come to their business and purchase merchandise. These people watch us a strong program, and they can tell a weak wrestler. This boy over here is a whooping boy. That's all what he is. He's a boy that...
One heck of a track record through here, and they give him no respect. I'll tell you what you got. If you're talking about putting Jerry Lawler in the ring with Snowman, you may as well put Al Bundy in there, because that's what kind of fight you're going to get. You won't have a fight. It's not a shadow of a doubt in my mind that if the King gets in the ring with Snowman, he'll be squashed in 2 minutes flat, and he knows it. Why did it take 15 security guards to take a wrestler out the building when the King could have taken care of it himself if he's the King? He ain't no King. He's a wimp. Now, I've spoke my piece. I'm finna let my Bohemian brother speak.
Bohemian brother, tell him, where have you seen this man? We got air time. You got to come over.
Hey, a true champion shouldn't deny another for a chance, you know. I look at it just like the question that you just asked me. Said no prejudice. He never experienced it when he's in this system, this terrible system. You bring your kids up, man. You think, man, that they're going to live their life out of TV, but that's wrong, man. You are fooling the children, man. Let them know the truth, man.
Who is this man?
Let them know.
Have you heard this man in the Bahamas?
I never hear about him. Who is
it? The king in Bahamas.
I never hear about him.
Do you ever hear him in Trinidad?
Through the Bohemian Ghost, he has wrestled. This man cannot be denied a championship shot at Mr. Who is Pillsbury Lawler?
Yes.
What is it? Tell me.
Snowman, your guest has had to speak. We're not talking about the Bohemians. We're not talking about nowhere. We're talking about right here. So get what you got off your chest, because we got to get on with the program.
That's you know what I got on my chest. You're going to give me Lawler before I leave here.
No, I'm not going to give you Lawler.
They're telling him to start from the bottom? Well, let me tell you where he started from. This man has defeated Ted DiBiase. He has defeated Dr. Death Steve Williams. He has defeated the Dockyard Dog. Where does he have to start from?
Jake Roberts.
If he hasn't did, he's defeated Jake the Snake Roberts. Lawler's nowhere near the men they are.
Minister Farrakhan is going to be in town soon. Will you be there, Eddie Marley?
Ridiculous.
Let me tell you something, Snowman. I said we was going to keep this control. We're going to keep control. You can get it.
The king out here.
House boy.
I tell you. Mike is live, Jerry.
Stand there. You can stand here.
Let him go back and take that seat.
Yeah.
Let me just say this, and I'll make this short and sweet. There's one thing that we can do to cut through all the crap that is going on out here, and that's all you're spouting out, Snowman.
The people are tired of you.
You know it. I don't care what the people are tired of. I'm going to tell you what I'm tired of. I'm tired of you and your big fat mouth. Do you understand what I'm saying? Now, the way we cut through all of this BS, brother, is all you got to do is, and I'm telling you, Eddie, if he wants a match, he's standing there just like he always is with his hand out. Well, I'm going to put something in it, Snowman. I'll give you a match anytime you want.
No, you don't need no match.
Is that the way to do this or not? You want to let him have a match? Hey.
You wait a minute, Jerry.
No, let me tell you something. Hey. You can stand up here, and you can take your shirt off, and you can flex those muscles, but you ain't impressing me. You might impress all of these people, and you might impress those two pencil-neck geeks you brought with you.
Well, you didn't impress me.
You don't impress me.
You don't impress me. That's what we are.
I'm here to tell you this. I'll fight you anytime, anywhere, and I don't care what you want to run your mouth about. I'll put you flat on your back right here, brother. Yeah, I will.
You got to
fight
with me.
Jerry the King Lawler and the Snowman finally met up in the ring. Fireworks flew. Take a look.
Well, this thing is underway. Jerry the King Lawler, the Snowman, they're both out center of the ring. They look like more like boxers right now. Neither one really close to the other one. Still right in the center. Man, I think sitting down in the parking lot is too close to this one. It's going to be explosive. And this looks more like Mike Tyson and Buster Douglas than anything. Lawler trying to get in. Snowman fires in with the left. Doesn't really connect.
Lawler shaking it off. Telling him no way. Both these men. Snowman throwing a couple of punches. Not even touching Lawler.
Both of them being very careful. Snowman coming in. He's got Lawler. Lawler fires in with a couple. Lawler going into the midsection.
Lawler all over the Snowman now. The crowd on its feet. All over the Mid-South Coliseum as Lawler all over the top of the Snowman. Jerry Calhoun now trying to restore a little order.
Well, there it was, the first flurry of action. And now Snowman on Lawler in the corner. He's got him trapped, trying to fire away in the midsection. Lawler tying him up. They're both over on the ropes. Lawler firing away to the midsection. Fires one to the side of the head. And both men still standing. As a matter of fact, everyone in this Coliseum tonight is on their feet. Snowman in on Lawler once again. The corner's a bad place to be. Lawler takes Snowman off his feet. Has him down. Lawler trying to keep the big man off his feet. Referee asking for a break. Can't get them apart. They're clenched in there tight.
I doubt if Calhoun's going to have any type of success of getting a break in this one. As the world champ gives him one, slides outside the ring, going to climb back up in there. The world heavyweight champion back up in the ring now.
Back in the center of the ring. Fitz doubles. Look at the shot Snowman fired off on Lawler. Man, he could have broken a rib with that. Snowman has him backed over. Fires off with a big haymaker. Lands another one. Lawler's reeling. Snowman going to work on Lawler. Lawler firing back off with a couple of fists. Snowman back down. Lawler going to work on Snowman. Snowman off his feet. Lawler firing away with fists. Trying to choke him. I have never seen two guys go at it like this before. Calhoun can't get Snowman off Lawler. He's trying to keep some kind of order in this. And as you said before, that's an almost impossible task.
Calhoun put down to the canvas. Lawler going in after the Snowman. Snowman turns him around over in the corner. Snowman laying in a couple of big rights now. Calhoun calling for the bell after the Snowman put Calhoun down on the canvas. Lawler and Snowman, look at this. Lawler just digging his fingers into the Snowman's eyes. Both of these guys going after each other, tooth and nail now.
The result of that match, Snowman loses on a technical loss. He went to the USWA, asked for a return World Heavyweight Championship match, and he got it with a special referee. Former boxing champion Leon Spinks. I'm sorry that we don't have film to show you the match, but as it happened, Leon Spinks is the special referee. Snowman defeated Jerry the King Lawler and became the new unified world heavyweight champion. Now, here's where we are now. Jerry the King Lawler is furious. He says Spinks was one-sided. Call the match towards Snowman. Snowman, on the other hand, says he was right down the middle. It was a fair fight, so to speak, and he is the new unified world heavyweight champion. While Lawler has asked for a rematch, the USWA has granted it. A return World Unified Heavyweight Championship match this week. No referee in the ring. What a big stipulation, and we'll have to see what happens as Jerry the King Lawler tries to regain his belt from the Snowman at the arena this week with no referee in the ring. That's what happened. New Unified World Heavyweight Champion. We got a lot more action here on Championship Wrestling. Let's take this break first. Wrestling excitement is hot and heavy Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. The USWA ring girls will be on hand. Also, prizes will be given away. Opening action, Ben Jordan takes on Scott Braddock. You'll see Joey Maggs in action against the Inhuman. Rick King battles dirty white boy Tom Burton. In a special grudge battle, Bill Superstar Dundee, the USWA Southern Heavyweight Champion, will have Tessa in his corner as he takes on dirty white boy Tony Anthony, accompanied with Ronnie P. Gotkin. And the main event for the World Unified Heavyweight Championship, a return match with no referee in the ring, as the Snowman puts his newly won title on the line against the former champion, Jerry the King Lawler, Wednesday night in Evansville. And don't miss USWA action in Fairfield, Illinois, Thursday, July 12th at Fairfield High School, sponsored by the JCs. Advance tickets on sale at Wayne County Bank, Fairfield National Bank, and from any JC member. And don't miss a minute of the action this Wednesday night. Evansville Coliseum, be there.
Well, the Snowman accomplished something that so many other people weren't able to accomplish. Or maybe I should rephrase that. Because everybody all over the country knows that Snowman, you didn't get the job done by yourself. As a matter of fact, you weren't very instrumental at all
in me losing the Unified World Heavyweight Championship, were you? How can you sleep at night, Snowman? How can you look at yourself in the mirror and call yourself a champion when you know that Leon Spinks, the former world boxing champion, was the man that cost me that title? Well, this week, Snowman, I'm coming right back at you, but there's a little bit different stipulation. You don't have a hand-picked referee this week because there won't be a referee in the ring. It's just me and you, man to man, a fight to a finish. The referee will be on the outside, and he'll only come in the ring for one thing, and that's to count the shoulders out. And I promise you this, they're going to be your shoulders, Snowman.
Fans, we promised you an action-packed USWA wrestling show that we've got. We're ready to go to Memphis, Tennessee to the studio. World Tag Team Champions, the Dirty White Boys, set for action against Rex King and Ben Jordan. Let's go to Memphis.
White Boys, Don Burton and the original Tony Anthony. Stepping into the ring. Here we go. Rex King wasted no time grabbing Tony Anthony. Remember, just a week ago, Rex King and Steve Dahl held these belts. Steve did not make it last week, and Rex had to defend those belts himself against the Dirty White Boys. They ended up doubling up and beating Rex King. Rex won the first fall of a 2-out-of-3-fall match, but lost the next two. Ben Jordan in there. Boy, this young man has come a long way in a short period of time. Doesn't have a lot of size, but he has made up for it with desire and training. Over to the corner. Does not go for the tag at this point with Rex King. Keeps the arm barred as Tony Anthony is back on his feet. Now Ben leans back to the corner, makes the tag. Here comes Rex King. Rex up on the middle rope. Ben Jordan with a boot to the midsection and a knee lift from Rex King. Rex over to the corner and used the right hand against Tom Burton since he just happened to be in the neighborhood. Ronnie P. Gossett, the Dirty White Boys manager at ringside, taking notes out here again, though, is downtown Bruno. Hi, Bruno. Becoming a fixture out here today with your notepad. Gossett tripped Rex King up. Last week, Gossett got involved in the action. Count is three, and that's it. And Ronnie P. Gossett gives him the victory here, not the Dirty White Boys, in his first fall, as Gossett held Rex King on the mat. Absolutely, absolutely ridiculous what Gossett got away with right there. Rex King, Ben Jordan, well, they're not staying around to complain about it. It's only the first fall of an expiration of time match, and I believe we're going to have time for at least one more fall. So Rex and his partner Ben Jordan do have a chance to come back and get even in the match and perhaps even win it here. But they lose the first fall and, again, give the big assist to Ronnie P. Gossett as the Dirty White Boys head back to the dressing room with a victory in fall one. We'll be back.
Wrestling excitement is hot and heavy Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. The USWA ring girls will be on hand. Also, prizes will be given away. Opening action, Ben Jordan takes on Scott Braddock. You'll see Joey Maggs in action against the Inhuman. Rex King battles Dirty White Boy Tom Burton in a special grudge battle. Bill Superstar Dundee, the USWA Southern Heavyweight Champion, will have Tessa in his corner as he takes on Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, accompanied with Ronnie P. Gossett. And the main event for the World Unified Heavyweight Championship, a return match with no referee in the ring, as the Snowman puts his newly won title on the line against the former champion, Jerry the King Lawler, Wednesday night in Evansville. And don't miss USWA action in Fairfield, Illinois, Thursday, July 12th at Fairfield High School, sponsored by the JCs. Advance tickets on sale at Wayne County Bank, Fairfield National Bank, and from any JC member. And don't miss a minute of the action this Wednesday night. Evansville Coliseum, be there.
King and Ben Jordan, here come the Dirty White Boys. Tom Burton and Tony Anthony. Gary Calhoun says, let's get it going. It's Tom Burton against Rex King. That's how fall number one ended, with Burton getting getting the pin on Rex King, but with Ronnie P. Gossett first tripping up Rex King and then holding him down to the mat while the referee made the count. Tom Burton picked him up with a hair. There's hair pulling by the Dirty White Boys. Snaps a reverse neck breaker on him. Slides a boot off the top of his head. Rex King back up on his feet. Comes after him with a fist flying. Tom Burton backs him into the corner and pounds him with that left fist. Drives the shoulder to the midsection and the chest. Hey, interesting. Downtown Bruno back out here taking notes again. And Tony Anthony turned and said, hey, you better go somewhere else with that pencil. Rex King puts the shoulders down, count of two. He got it! We've got ourselves a tie right here. One fall apiece. Rex King gets the shoulders pinned on Tom Burton. And I tell you what happened this time. Ronnie P. Gossett was a bit distracted by Downtown Bruno, interestingly enough, and was not able to interfere. And therefore, we've got an even match. One fall apiece. You complain all you want to, Gossett. It was pinned. 1-2-3 right there in the middle of the ring. It is one fall apiece. Tom Burton not happy about it. Tony Anthony not happy. They are steamed, but it's not going to do any good. They are with one fall apiece now. And they're going to have to come back for a third fall here. And perhaps a deciding fall, depending on time. Remember, in an expiration of time match, you can have three, four, five falls, depending on the time. But it's even. As Rex King has proved what we had thought all along, that if you could keep Gossett out of the action, that he could do a pretty good job of handling the Dirty White Boys. So,
boy, the action's hot in Memphis, Tennessee. The falls are even. One fall apiece. We'll be ready for the third fall. But first, let's take this break on USWA Championship Wrestling. Let's go back to Memphis and see what happens in the third fall.
We get them in here, we will be set to go with third fall action. First fall went to the Dirty White Boys as Tom Burton got the pin. Here come Ben Jordan and Rex King back in. They won the second fall as King got a pin. And it was a very upset bunch of Dirty White Boys and Ronnie P. Gossett that left here. I'm not going anywhere with them. That's not my belt, no doubt about that. But you've got some action to take care of right here. And Ronnie P. Gossett, your guys are back to even. It's like starting over right now.
Not anything starting over. You watch this last fall. I'll make you think starting over. I didn't come over here to talk about this. I told you last week, Dave Brown. I told you so. I hate to be one to run off the room, but what are you looking at on this table? The World Tag Team Belt. Held by my boys, the Dirty White Boys. I promised you that they would be the champions, and Ronnie Gossett delivered. Now, how do you like that?
You delivered, all right. You're the one responsible for it, because I remember how the belts were won. I saw you holding his foot over there.
You saw. The end result is on this table right here, the World Tag Team Belt.
Well, it's something you shouldn't be proud of, but you do have the belts, there's no doubt about it. The Dirty White Boys have the belts, and as we saw in the first fall, Ronnie P. Gossett is still not above interfering in the situation in order to get the Dirty White Boys a victory in the match. Downtown Bruno back out here taking notes. He was not looked upon kindly by the Dirty White Boys as he was out here during the last fall. Tony Anthony has just turned and seen him again. Didn't say anything to him, but Bruno has backed off about 15 feet farther back from the ring. Dirty White Boy, victim of the backdrop, put on him by Rex King, as Rex King continues to look very good. Rex King and Ben Jordan in here. Rex working on that left arm. Only as defined in the terms of managers, Ronnie P. Gossett. Ronnie insulting the folks who are in the building here today. Some folks got no room to talk, right? Well, anyway, Tom Burton down on the mat. Ben Jordan with a cover. Ben couldn't hold it for the three count. Looked like maybe Rex King and Ben Jordan had a chance of getting a very crucial third fall victory here. That would put them up 2-1. And with the time situation, just might give them the victory as time is beginning to run a little bit short here. The winner of this third fall will be in good shape to be the winner. As it is now, one fall apiece. Dirty White Boy trying for the tag. Don Burton missed it. He didn't miss it by much, but he missed it. Tony Anthony says, what do you mean missed? Well, he missed. That's all there was to it. Rex Gang. He's in the right hand. Tom Burton finds himself in trouble. He was pinned last fall. Rex King had to tear that left arm loose from the shoulder socket. Reversal by Burton puts Rex King into the rope. He caught him with a knee coming off of there. Here's Tony Anthony. Big, rugged Tony Anthony. Oh, just goes full speed into Rex King back in the corner. Oh, my goodness. Anthony with a reverse neck breaker on Rex King. Tony Anthony. Picking Rex King up by the hair now. Kicks him back into the ropes and through the rope, Rex. Oh, Gossett's got a shoe off. Look out. Hammers Rex King in the top of the head with that shoe. Boy, I tell you, this Gossett gets worse and worse, I think. Disgusting what Ronnie P. Gossett does at ringside. Bruno, I might know you defend him. You're the only person in the world that would try to defend Ronnie P. Gossett for what he just did right there.
He's a different mother, Dave. He's a different mother. A good man like me, defending himself.
Yep. That's the version according to Downtown Bruno, which doesn't bear a lot of resemblance to the truth. 4-3 in motion, says Ronnie P. Gossett. That's what he thinks of the Dirty White Boys right now. The match is even, remember, one fall apiece. Tony Anthony hits nothing but the mat as Rex King moves out of the way. Over to the corner and the tag on Ben Jordan. Ben comes in. He's been watching all of this. He comes in with a good drop kick. Puts Tony Anthony on the mat. Another one for Tom Burton. Grabs Anthony. Backs into the ropes. Look out, a reversal. Ronnie P. Gossett reaches for it, distracts him. Anthony drops him down. Rex King's trying to help, but he got the three count. The Dirty White Boys get the win, and again, you got to give Ronnie P. Gossett the assist. The hands are raised to the Dirty White Boy. I heard you, Ronnie P. Gossett, and again, I say you can't be very proud of the way you guys continue to win these matches.
Still World Tag Team Champions.
Piece of cake.
Wasn't even a title match, and help in both falls you won from Ronnie P. Gossett.
Ronnie P. Gossett getting involved again with the Dirty White Boys. He does that, as you know, from time to time. Speaking of the Dirty White Boys, Tony Anthony got involved recently with superstar Bill Dundee, the Southern Heavyweight Champion, in a match in Dallas, Texas. In fact, tossed Tessa around the ring. Dundee is furious. He wants back at Tony Anthony. Let's go back to that segment in Dallas, Texas. Take a look at what happened.
Hey, you idiot, did I hear you right? There's a $10,000 bounty on that mentally retarded Dundee's head. Well, let me tell you something. The Dirty White Boys and Ronnie Gossett love money, and we collect bounties. Tony, you got 1 minute to beat that moron, and if you can't beat him, I'm pulling in my other white boy, Tom Burton. Get in there.
Well, here's Tony Anthony trying to collect the dough.
I can do a lot on $10,000. I can have a lot of buffets. We can travel around. So my boy is taking him out. You got that?
Tony Anthony, all former superstar Bill Dundee, and although you can't see her, Tessa quite worried. Tessa's getting in the ring. Tessa's getting in the ring. Tessa,
come on, Tony. You only got 30 seconds. Come on, Tony.
Look at Tessa. Oh no! Tony Anthony picks up Tessa. Fire up. Superstar Bill Dundee, and he's a man possessed.
If you ask me, that Jezebel didn't have no reason to be in there anyway.
Trying to protect her man, and now she may have gotten hurt in the process. Both 30 white boys.
Here goes Billy Joe Travis. Hit the ring.
Alexa. Oh, I hope she's okay.
Why?
Why do you care?
She's a lovely girl.
I guess you're in love with her now.
She's a lovely girl.
I guess you love her now.
Well, the superstar, I think she's crying.
You'd cry too if you got thrown around like that, Junkie.
Well, I guess the dirty white boy trying to build his reputation or collect a bounty or do something to get the ire of Bill Superstar Dundee up, and that he has gotten, I can assure you. Let's now go to Dallas, Texas. Craig is standing by. Superstar Bill Dundee is coming into the ring for a match. Let's go to Craig in Dallas.
We've got action in the ring with the superstar, as there you see the lovely Tessa. Holding the ropes open for her man, and then vice versa, as Tessa makes her way into the ring. The opponent for superstar Bill Dundee is the Black Knight. The Southern heavyweight champion, superstar Bill Dundee, a man in love, and I think he mentioned something about marriage. More on that, I'm sure, in the days and weeks to come. The Black Knight trying to take charge of the superstar, but the Southern heavyweight champion with a big backdrop. Now a clothesline by superstar Bill Dundee, a drop kick. And superstar Bill Dundee with a little strutting and out, a little kissing. The Black Knight staggering after a virtual bevy of moves by the superstar. And now, superstar Bill Dundee gets the Black Knight in an arm bar. Now pulls him over on the hip toss, keeping the arm bar locked in. Helps it out with a leg scissors. Bill Dundee going to work on the left arm of the Black Knight. And now he's trying to get the mask off. The Black Knight is about to see the light of day, I do believe. Oh, a stop by the superstar. Black Knight a little bit disoriented. Bill Dundee with a headlock after the takeover on the Black Knight. And now a pull of the hair, and that will break the hold. Black Knight, pretty big man in there again. Superstar Bill Dundee, who may make up for his lack of size with strength and skill. Oh, it's time to make a wish. No, he goes for the spinning toe hold. Wraps it around, puts pressure on the knee. He's got it locked in there. Now he puts more pressure on the standing toe hold. And now that will pull your hamstring out quite quickly. Now, favoring that leg is the Black Knight. And Dundee goes back to work on the arm, but the Black Knight reverses. And now Dundee's had just about enough of this. After the yank of the hair, a nice takedown, go behind by superstar Bill Dundee, now with a half Nelson on the Black Knight. Back to work on that arm, but the Black Knight breaks it up with a rake of the eyes. To the turnbuckle goes the head of the Southern heavyweight champion. Now a chop. Black Knight in control here, but no! Body home. Bill Dundee sets him up. A series of rights. To the rope, and it's time for the Black Knight to say, Superstar Sleeper locked in tight on the Black Knight. And I think there's checking once. taking place. Good night, Black Knight. And your winner is the Southern Heavyweight Champion, Superstar Bill Dundee, as he says good morning to Mr. Knight. We'll take a break and be back with more in a minute.
Wrestling excitement is hot and heavy Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. The USWA ring girls will be on hand. Also, prizes will be given away. Opening action, Ben Jordan takes on Scott Braddock. You'll see Joey Maggs in action against the Inhuman. Rick King battles dirty white boy Tom Burton. In a special grudge battle, Bill Superstar Dundee, the USWA Southern Heavyweight Champion, will have Tessa in his corner as he takes on dirty white boy Tony Anthony, accompanied with Ronnie P. Gossett. And the main event for the World Unified Heavyweight Championship, a return match with no referee in the ring, as the Snowman puts his newly won title on the line against the former champion, Jerry the King Lawler, Wednesday night in Evansville. And don't miss USWA action in Fairfield, Illinois, Thursday, July 12th at Fairfield High School, sponsored by the Jaycees. Advance tickets on sale at Wayne County Bank, Fairfield National Bank, and from any JC member. And don't miss a minute of the action this Wednesday night. Evansville Coliseum, be there.
Just like I told you, Jerry the King Lawler, I know if I run behind you long enough and you hid behind the promoters, Eddie Marley, you hid behind all the people, you had all your protection. There's nowhere to go now. Now you signed your own death warrant. I wonder what you think about that. Look, Lawler, I'm the best that did it and got away with it. Let me tell you something. Like I told the good people here, that's the way it's going to be. I brought my man Leon Sphinx. Evansville, I told you, this man been putting out on all you good people out there, but you know what? The man with the thunder cook is the big guns. Let me tell you something. When I hit him, he thought it was Chocolate City, but he was looking the 1, 2, 3. Guess what? The man that stayed toe-to-toe with Muhammad Ali, the world's greatest of all time, Leon Sphinx, the man called it. Straight down the middle, Lola. Now what you gonna do about it? I got the goal. I am the world's unified champion. And what you gonna do about it? Just like I told you, Lola, you can't beat me. Now you sign your own death warrant. That's crazy, man. You don't want a referee at all? Now you don't have any protection. What you gonna do when these big thunder cookers go down on you? Evansville, I'm the world's champion, the Snowman.
You're watching USWA Championship Wrestling. We're going right back to the Sportatorium in Dallas, Texas. I understand Jeff Jarrett is headed to the ring.
Simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett making his way to the ring. Did he just call for Skandor Akbar? You got to remember. Okay, if Skandor Akbar can hear us in the back. Apparently, Jeff Jarrett wants to talk over something with him. Remember last week, Jeff Jarrett was just one of the many people that Skandor Akbar tried to sign, offering them $5,000 bonuses for signing. David Gold, the opponent for Jeff Jarrett. Nice arm drag gets things started. And David Gold complains to referee Bronco Lubitsch about a pull of the hair. Jeff Jarrett, a man who has a dream. That dream, the World Heavyweight Championship. Once again, a complaint by Mr. Gold about pulling the hair. And General Skandor Akbar, just off your screen, has made his way to ringside. As action continues inside the ring, Gold with a headlock. Him to the right shoulder block by David Gold. Step over. And Jarrett with a nice hip toss. And there you see the checkbook. Skandor Akbar has been out here trying to sign members of Devastation Incorporated, new members, that is. And General Akbar very much wanting Jeff Jarrett into the stable of Devastation Incorporated. A headlock by Jeff Jarrett. Gold breaks it by sending him to the ropes. And a shoulder block
High, simply irresistible. And a reversal on the hip top. And Jarrett shows that right that scares David Gall back into the corner. The fans fully behind, simply irresistible, Jeff Jarrett. And now, Jarrett wants action back in the ring. Gold spending a lot of time complaining. Now, into the corner they go. Gold, not a clean break. He gets him in the right, and a pair of fingers into the eye. And now, into the corner goes Jeff Jarrett, David Gold. Now chokes him over the top rope. Jarrett, with the fans behind him, gets the reversal. Nailed. There the goal. There's a right to the choppers. One more time. Into the corner they go. Jarrett sets him up. Reversal. As Gold and Jarrett, nobody home. Now to the middle rope. So simply irresistible with a drop kick. There's one. That's two. Irresistible, Jeff Jarrett.
Big action out of Big D. There's action happening in the River City, too. We're going to the studio in Memphis, Tennessee. The Inhuman, one huge, awesome wrestler, is ready for action. Take it away, Dave Brown.
Kendall stepping up onto the ring apron right now. Jerry Calhoun, the referee, into the ring. Here he comes, kind of staring at the lights again and looking all around. I'm not sure if he's seeing anything or not, but he's looking. Talking about the Inhuman steps up on the ring apron right now through the ropes. And here we go. One fall, 15-minute time limit match. Radford Tindall against the Inhuman. And downtown Bruno wanders out at ringside with his notepad in hand once again. The Inhuman going to work on Tindall, wasting no time, taking control.
I like this guy Inhuman. He's almost as good looking as I am, Dave. You know it?
Well, I have no comment on that, downtown Bruno. Except to say the way the Inhuman wrestles, I would not be at all surprised that he's your kind of wrestler. He drops down on Radford Tindall with the upper arm. Haven't done anything illegal yet. Two and three. Well, I guess he doesn't have to. He got the victory. The time, only 51 seconds in that match as the Inhuman, now this is unnecessary, grabs Radford Tindall and throws him into the ropes. Tindall flipping out on the ring apron, trying to shake the cobwebs as the Inhuman now goes wandering around and downtown Bruno just saying, hey, we need to talk. What's he trying to do, sign him to a contract? The Inhuman doesn't seem to be totally aware that downtown Bruno is anywhere around. Well, anyway, the Inhuman gets the win. 51 seconds again the time. We will be back with more USWA action.
USWA in your hometown. It's America's number one fundraiser. USWA Wrestling. The stars, the action, the excitement. USWA Wrestling. For more information on how you can raise money for your organization, write the USWA, Post Office Box 1783, Hendersonville, Tennessee, 37077, or call 615-824-8523. USWA Wrestling, America's number one fundraiser.
Wrestling fans, it looks like we're all out of time this week on USWA Championship Wrestling, but I can tell you this much. Jerry the King Lawler and the Snowman, you talk about a feud that's come to a boil. It's beyond the boiling point. The next match scheduled to be in the ring, no referee. There won't be a referee in the ring. But the Unified Heavyweight Championship will be on the line. You'll want to see that. Also, the Dirty White Boy has stirred the dander up of superstar Bill Dundee. I don't think I've seen Bill this hot in years. And he wants it Tony Anthony in the worst way. There's superstars in the USWA and more great action to come each and every week. You be sure to join us and get out to see USWA Championship Wrestling when it comes to the arena in your town. Until next week, Michael St. John saying, so long, everyone.
The The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of Championship Wrestling.